The project began with, I think, a phone call from Hervé and Virilio. So it started with understanding from Virilio what he wanted to accomplish. He wanted to do something. He wanted to touch this topic, which was a very complicated topic about human migration for political, environmental, and economic reasons, and started to talk about it. And it was very fascinating for us to hear him speak about his, his impressions about the state of the world. We have like slightly different reflections on it, and which was very, very good because we had total freedom to really imagine a piece. It was not dictated by Paul at all.
Dernière nouvelle. En 2008, 36 millions de personnes ont été déplacées pour des raisons climatiques, catastrophes naturelles, conflits.
When you turn on the news, you see the migration, you see the very scary, and very heart-wrenching kind of scenes, that one encounters. We wanted to tell the story without that kind of passion. We wanted to tell it through facts. And if we could just let the data do the talking, it could possibly produce an effect, a strong emotional effect, the way that photography and film does.
As we began the pull-in information and the data, discovered what seemed to be unrelated events were really deeply connected to each other. And the kind of exposure of cause and effect was really, I think, a very interesting aspect of it, because usually these pieces are morselated and they're looked at singularly. So that raising the water level being raised is seen as a simple problem for cities. One never understands what it means in terms of migration, in terms of temperature, in terms of many other things. And I think that's one of the strong aspects of this piece, is that it really relates and pulls together what appear to be disparate events as being really thematic and very important in the relationship to each other.
We wanted to make the data immersive, and it seemed obvious that we would use the globe in some way, or maps. By making the space panoramic in the round, we're able to use both the globe and maps at the same time, and flat maps. So the globe orbits the space, and you are in the middle of it. And it prints data, and it erases the data and lets it behave also according to geocoded information. It had something to do with turning the world inside out, of like standing in the middle of it somehow, impossibly, and understanding it all at once.
I think it's interesting that the graphics are data driven, and we try to keep it as kind of unaffected by our emotions and feelings as possible. But when it came to sound, we had a great deal of fun thinking about the sound. And I think the sound is very emotional and very important to the piece and adds another dimension.
Peace is a living, breathing piece. It was done, we started working on it maybe 9 years ago, 8, 9 years ago. And, every year the world has changed. And every year the piece would change. It was a while until we came to this point where we really feel like the world had changed so dramatically that we needed to update it. And as we move forward and hopefully continue to tour the piece, it will continue to change.
But it's a rebirth of the piece.
Yeah.
And it's amazing within, I think that was 2008, 7 years later, the population of the world has increased by another billion, I think. And the number of refugees and migration is also probably more than quadrupled, probably five times the amount that it was in 2008. And so I think being able to to understand the history and see the change over a period of time is really critical.
Of all of the work that we've done with the Cartier in collaboration, this piece is going to constantly be present. It's not a project in the past. The world changes and reflects the world. I expect that the reception will be stronger now than it was before, because when we showed it, the data visualization was not so common. People didn't really understand how to take the piece. Is this art? Is this information? What is it? Why is it in a gallery? You know, I think now data visualization is more part of everyday expressions, like writing, you know, and I think that climate change in general, and then this issues around politics, global and local, you know, are very poignant. And this piece does not directly touch that, but indirectly, you know, there are many, many interconnected elements, you know, and one is the seamlessness, you know, of the world, that just like global warming, it doesn't understand political borders. You know, it may start in certain places where environmental conditions are not regulated, but consequences transgress geopolitical borders, and that's, I think, the world we live in many different ways, politically, environmentally.
There is an element of people saying this is all nonsense and we don't have to pay attention to it. And I think this piece really refocuses the fact that this interrelated, interconnected series of events is really very serious, and it's something that we should pay attention to.
We can no longer look at nation states. It's just, that's a different way of thinking the world. We're now looking at a global consciousness where people move everywhere, just like pollution, you know, just like our seas are transforming, just the effects of not regulated pollution and so forth creates problems that have no borders. And I think we're seeing kind of a borderless condition that we don't know how to monitor. We don't know what to do because our systems that we have in place can't deal with that.
I think that what we're understanding now is the complexity of what is the cause of these problems. And I think that's something that politically has to be addressed and taken on, because otherwise it'll simply be, if we do this, that'll resolve it and forget about it and everybody's happy. So I think that, for me, one of the nice things about the piece is it does point to the complexity and the interrelatedness of these conditions, and it has to be addressed in a much deeper way than it has been politically to date.
Well, and that's with COP21, we're hoping that policymakers, people that are actually thinking about the interconnectivity of these forces, have a chance to see the show, and that it, even if it moves, you know, just some people that are typically come to art museums, or a couple more people that don't typically come to art museums, it would be, you know, really worth it for them. So these topics are not just for policymakers. These topics are really to be touched on by artists and thinkers, philosophers, you know, and that's why, you know, the piece, our piece, I feel very, very proud of it. It started with a philosopher and it ended with architects and artists and statisticians and geographers. I mean, you know, that's the way that the world needs to really think across disciplines, across borders.